Hi everyone, welcome back. We are back on Sally Jane. And what we are doing is we are doing some final jobs and repairs and tidies up and cleans ready for a new owner taking her. I'm going to try and get most of it done this weekend and next weekend so that they can have her in like 3 weeks' time. So what I need to do is, first up, I need to drain down the water tanks. The water tanks are full. But what you'll notice, if I show you here, is that it runs fine and then it dies off because the flow of water to the tap from the tank isn't fast enough. So it's going to take me ages, but I need to drain down the water tank. And then what I have is I have some 90 degree. She's a mess because we're busy moving everything over to our rows, but what I have is some 90 degree pipe inserts. So where the pipe is getting nipped, because it has to do, at the moment it's doing a big loop back on itself and it's nipping up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut it, put a 90 in. Now I would say you shouldn't really use 90s as a restrictive, but I'm willing to bet that flows better than a piece of tube nipped only a millimetre or so wide, hence why the taps are an issue. So I'm going to do one cut where it comes out of the water tank in the engine bay, because if you remember, I'll show you in a bit, but it's got a little stick coming out and then the hose that kind of doubles back on itself and it's nipping. So I'm just going to trim that. So there's a little bit of hose from the water tank, then a 90, run straight through the bulkhead. And then under the cupboard down there, in the little cubby hole, there is the water pump, which I've replaced. And again, it's nipping, so I'm going to probably end up putting two of these to create a U. So water comes in, down, round and into the pump. Silicon sealed all the way round the seat and all the way under the seat there, in this corner here. Where, and I put new sticking foam down to allow it to sit in without rattling like I did on the back one. So the only thing left to do now, silicon-wise, is I've just got to pop this canopy off. I need to run a bead along the back of that seat. And then we are fully siliconed up. So I'm going to quickly do that now. And then I'm just going to sit and wait a bit for the water. And then we'll get into the water. So I'll be back in a minute. Right, so that's a nice silicon bead. Ran all the way down and around. I'm hoping you can kind of see that. We've gone all the way down and around and then down and around there. So once that's drying, I can't wash and polish that and get those rusty marks of that steel yet, so that's got to wait now for that to dry. So my next job, I've had to stop the water pump from pumping because it was getting a little bit hot, but my next job is I need to take these stickers off. Now I've got them on both sides, obviously the new guy's not me, so I need to take those off. I'm going to do this side, and when we pull the boat out of the water to lift the pedestrian transport, I'll quickly turn it round first and we'll take those off. It's a bit windy for me to be fanning around turning the boat round today. So I'm going to quickly do that, and then that needs 24 hours to dry before I can wash against it with silicon. And then after that I'll come back and I'll set the water draining again. So yeah, long day, slowly going, but I am getting through some of the jobs. Whether I'll get the water pump fully done and everything today, it's draining really slowly, but that's because the pipe's nipped so you can't get the water out. So we'll see how we get on. That might be a job for tomorrow to finish off draining, maybe come back next weekend and finish off the plumbing adjustment and the pump and everything, but we'll see how we get on. We're gonna get that sticker off, and then we have to get that speaker fixed and then drain some more water down. So I'll be back in a bit and we'll show you how it goes. Right, so that's the hateful head smashing fire extinguishers back up, all done, tested, ready until 2023 now. And this is the problem with the water, but we're still draining, so it's not. It's this pipe here, can you see it's pinched? I reckon if I put 90 into there, just there, it goes into that little bit, then into that little bit, and cut this loop out altogether. I reckon that will almost invariably fix the problem, but for now this tank is still full, so He's draining still, so I'm going to go back to it and I'm going to fix the speaker that's not working now. Take the name off the side. I've refitted all fire extinguishers. I've siliconed around. So, yeah. So, I found the problem with the speakers. This little wire should be in that connection there. So I'm going to quickly put that back in and you should, in a couple of seconds, hear music. So, let's see if we can just have us quickly balance you in and angle you up. Hopefully that's seen something useful. If not, we'll edit it out, I guess. But ready? There you go. So let's make sure that the rest are all tight. There we go. So now we go to my little phone.
Yep, that is Chaka Khan with Steve Winwood and ahead of Higher Love Gladys Knight
and
Midnight Train to Georgia. Have you got your tickets?
Here we go. Yeah. Down in the UK, so that's left balance.
Do not miss.
Right balance. Live. She's still terrific. Both of them.
These are the weekend anthems. I'm Richard Allenson. The song
superb. So there we go. All working. So that's one more job done. So. We're getting there slowly. I'm not going to get a chance to do the polishing and everything today, I don't think. I'll come back tomorrow and the water tank's nowhere near drained. I'm having to do it a little bit of time because I don't want to overheat the pumps. It's not pulling enough water through to keep yourself cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start tying it up here, get my table up and out of the way. And then I've got a carpet cleaner. I'm going to clean all there. I'm going to get my dehumidifier set up here. I'm going to clean it and leave it overnight, drain it out and wedge that open because I want to clean that bit of carpet in there as well. So yeah, and then when I come back tomorrow, more water tank draining, fix that problem and get polishing. Hi all, this is Future Dave reminding you that past Dave's an idiot. So I forgot to take the GoPro with me. This is a few pictures from my camera instead. That's the 90 degree on the water pipe feed from the water tank in the engine bay. I only needed a 190, it was enough to fix the water problem. Flow is lovely now on all taps. This is a transom shield. I finally got around to cleaning and polishing her, so she's no longer kind of creamy brownie but actually sharp white, and you know, you can see we've got a good measure of shiny reflection in there. I use the same polisher and the same chemical guys, kind of two-in-one polisher and glazing compound that I use on the rest of the hole in the summer. And then this next bit is I started cleaning the decks, or finally did clean the decks with the Onyx Super Yacht Teak Cleaner. That top bit in front of the driver's seat there, you can see that's actually cleaned with it already. And the darker bit at the bottom is uncleaned. And then you can see the end of the transom here after we'd sanded it back, resealed it and cleaned it all properly. So that's now the teak on the actual bathing platform at the back, looking, strangely enough, like brand new. So that's it. That is all the jobs done on SJ now. Thank you for watching for the past couple of years on SJ, and I hope you stick around whilst we find new adventures with Wild Rose. And in the meantime, everyone, stay safe, and I will see you all later. Take care. Bye bye.